Hello students, today we'll discuss the collection, distribution and transportation of milk. In this topic we will discuss about why the collection of milk is essential, why there is need of for the collection of milk. Because milk is produced on small scattered farms in rural areas where demand for milk is very less. So there is high demand for milk in the urban areas. The quantity of milk produced on this small farm is very less, so transportation of milk to urban areas is not possible for individual milk producers. Sorry for the interruption. So also there are no chilling transportation facilities with him in the village level or in the rural areas. So therefore there is a need of milk collecting centers. These collecting centers cool and transport the milk to the urban areas. And these collecting centers are run by following agencies. First, by individual milk producer. The milk producer in rural areas keeps some milk for his household consumption and remaining milk is given directly to consumer or milk collectors. And second one, by urban milk producer. The milk producers living nearby cities keep some milch animals. Milk produced on these farms is directly sold out to consumers in cities or milk contractors. And then third one is the milk contractor. This method of milk collection is not suitable because milk producer is not getting good price for his milk. Then fourth one is the milk collectors. Milk collectors may collect the milk in villages from milk producers and sell it to wholesalers or distributors or directly among consumers. And fifth one is the cooperative organizations. This is most suitable method for milk collection for rural milk producer, being they are the owners of this cooperative organization. Profit goes to the producer directly. Then we will discuss about some advantage of milk collecting centers or country milk receiving stations, that CMRS, of collection cum chilling centers. So first advantage is that the shipping of milk from receiving stations to the processing plants or market is by truck or tankers. So the shipping of the milk from the receiving station to the processing plants or market is by the truck or tankers. And the second one, if volume of milk at one station is not sufficient, truck may fill at different stations. The buyers can visit those farms from where poor quality milk is delivered and assist the owner in improving quality of his product. And the producer is able to see his milk being sampled and graded. Then we will discuss about the location of CMRS. While selecting locations for CMRS, following points should be considered. First one, there should be adequate milk and water supply. Proximity to good road and rail lines. It should have electricity supply. It should have sewage disposal facility. And it should have cooling and storage facility. Then we will discuss about the objective of CMRS. The first objective of CMRS is to provide easy transport of milk to processing plant. The equipments at CMRS are automatic scale balance, milk pump, milk coolers, can washer, boiler, compressor, storage tank. And then we will discuss about the transportation of milk. Milk, being highly perishable product, should be transported immediately to processing plant where it will be processed and distributed. okay, because the milk is highly perishable and it should be transported immediately to processing plant where it will be processed and distributed. The proper utilization of total milk production of country depends upon its transportation, which extends from farm to the house. Then we will discuss about the means of transportation. The common means of milk transportation are as follows. For the first one, carrying milk on head or head load system. This is generally practiced to a short distance with little quantity of milk. It is practiced all over the country, but mostly in hilly areas. It is cheap means of the transportation. This method is also practiced by milk producers who are residing nearby the cities. Then second one is the shoulder sling. More milk up to 40 kg can be carried by man using shoulder sling. Hence, it is easier than head load. Then third one is the pack animals. Different types of animals are used to carry milk from the surrounding villages to the town in different parts of the country. Horses are used in Punjab, camels are used in Rajasthan, mules are used in the Himalayas. Then 40 to 80 kgs of milk can be transported by one animal. It is practiced to a distance of 8 to 10 kilometers. The cost of transportation is lower than the shoulder sling. The next one is the bullock carts. It is very rarely used as means of transportation of fluid milk. In Gujarat, this method is used to carry the milk. It is very slow process. Then next one is the cycle. This is commonly used method of milk transportation. It is used in all parts of the country. This method is very useful in milk collections from village producer. One man can carry 2 to 4 cans having the capacity of 40 kg. Cycle can be used for distance of 15 to 20 kilometers. It is a quick method of transportation. The next one is the bulk transportation of milk. Transportation of milk in a bulk is highly specialized undertaking involving the employment of long distance in milk industry. Bulk transportation in dairy industry has covered high quantity to a longer distance within a short period. Then we will discuss about the means of bulk transportation. The first one is the road transportation, rail transportation, and water transportation. Then we will discuss the road transportation. In that, motor truck. The motor trucks for transportation of milk was first used to replace the horses in local condition, one for morning and another for evening collection. Cans are provided with ice cone, which keeps the milk cool during the transportation. The system of transportation handles small quantity of milk. The capacity is 0.5 to 3 ton and distance covered is 15 kilometers. In this system, the investment in can is the more. The next one is the tanker. The first tanker was used in California in 1912. The first tanker was glass lined. Nowadays, stainless steel tankers are used. The tankers are provided with air pump and mechanical pump for loading and unloading of the milk. The capacity of tanker is 5 to 10 tons and distance covered is 80 kilometer or more. Then we will discuss about the advantages of the tankers. The first advantage is that the quicker mode of transportation and it is having a low cost for the transportation. It is a better temperature control, more time and labor saving. It is a labor saving and it consumes a less time actually. no investment in the cans. And then advantage of road transportation in that loading and unloading of milk is possible directly at godowns of sellers and buyers. Cheaper than rail over a short distance, less time consuming. Then we will discuss about the rail transportation. There are three means of transportation, that is, first one is the refrigerated cars. It was firstly used in 1887. It may carry milk up to 2000 liters. Refrigerated cars are also used for transportation of skim milk, condensed milk. Then next one is the railway wagons. The capacity of railway wagon is 11 tons or more. Generally, it is used to transport skim milk powder. The next one is the tank cars. The modern milk tanker consists of two glass lined coatings with capacity of 5 tons or more. During transport, the temperature of milk varies by only 1 to 2 degrees centigrade. The cars are painted with light color externally. Because the light color absorbs the less sunlight. The advantages of rail transportation is it is cheaper than road over long distance, a large quantity of milk can be handled, better temperature control, and more labor saving. Then water transportation. Boats have been also used in some parts of country to carry milk from villages situated nearby big rivers to the nearest town lying on the bank of same river. So the refrigerated rooms or tanks are constructed in the boat. Then chilling of milk. Why there is need of for the chilling of or cooling for the milk? So though milk is produced in a clean and under hygienic condition, it consists of small amount of microorganisms. Milk being the best medium for microorganisms, and when favorable temperature is available, these few bacteria grow and multiply speedily and thus spoil the milk. For checking the growth and multiplication of bacteria, milk must be cooled below 50 degree Fahrenheit, means 10 degrees centigrade, immediately after milking, to reduce the multiplication or growth of the microorganism, milk should be cooled first. Then the types of cooler, we will discuss about the different types of cooler in the milk coolers in the next lecture.